All right, we're going to stay right there on the Hill, where later today we expect the House to take up the Senate bill or some kind of bill. Lloyd Doggett is a Democratic congressman from Texas. He's a member of the Budget Committee. He's been arguing to end the Bush-era tax cuts for the very wealthy. Congressman, good morning and Happy New Year to you. And I take
Happy New Year.
Means you are likely a yes vote.
Well, I'd like to be, but I'd also like to see the fine print in this agreement that I doubt very many members of the Senate were able to study carefully at 2 in the morning and to evaluate the trade-offs that were made here. Clearly, there's some good features of it. I'm pleased they reached a last-minute agreement, but that agreement presented on Midnight Eve, instead of turning into a pumpkin at midnight, became landmark legislation, and we need to evaluate it very closely.
What's your sense of, so you want to evaluate it. We've talked to a lot of congressmen this morning, some of whom have said they're likely no's or likely yes's, but all of them have said, I want to see it to determine, make that determination. What is your guess as to how this is going to go in the end? If it is put to a vote, it will likely pass?
I think it will pass in some form. There's still a question as to whether amendments are offered here. And of course, as you've also noted, big question here that having circumvented the dangers of the cliff here at New Year's, that we face the Valentine Day cliff and perhaps the April Fool's Day cliff because of all the things that are not in this agreement.
So heading into those cliffs, which I will not name again, although you name them quite aptly, Where does your party stand? Where does the White House stand in its ability to negotiate heading into the debt ceiling discussion? There are critics who say the president has shown that he is willing to budge, to come off his sticking points when push comes to shove. So is he likely to cave when it gets to the debt ceiling?
Well, I think the president has tried to provide leadership for the entire country, and I applaud that. I think that Republicans have taken away a message in the past. I voted against the late night agreement that was reached in 2010 as being very unbalanced. Republicans took away from that experience that if they are hard enough, difficult enough, extreme enough, and just keep pushing, that eventually they'll get major concessions from the president. They certainly did not get as many concessions this time as they did in 2010. The president has said no negotiations over the debt ceiling, but he also said that $250,000 was the level at which we would see a return to the Clinton-level tax levels. I believe that $450,000 is hardly middle income in America. It may be the median income of Republican campaign contributors, but it's certainly not the median income of a family in Central Texas.
No, it definitely
now
isn't.
Now that's enshrined permanently in the law, and that's a very troubling feature.
It is a very troubling feature that we have defined the middle class as starting at $450,000 a year. That's another battle for another day. Is the president, I mean, is it wise for the president to come out and say no negotiations on the debt ceiling? That's a real problem. This was a real problem as well, but the debt ceiling could shut American government down.
Well, we have to stand behind the full faith and credit of the United States. Also, the related question of how we handle the across-the-board spending cuts or sequestration, it is encouraging in that regard that there was a precedent set, an insistence that that was not all coming out of healthcare research and educational opportunity, that half of it was revenue for this postponement. But that looms very largely as we go forward.
So, Congressman, thank you very much for joining us. We appreciate your insight into this, and we wish you the best of the new year.